Hello everyone, welcome back to the Scratch tutorial. So in this particular video we are going to see block palettes under motion block menu. Okay, so these are the block palettes under the motion block menu. So for this explanation of block menus I'll be using offline version. You don't find much difference between online and offline version, most probably they are same. So I'm using offline version for the convenience of internet connections. Okay, I don't have internet connections very often, so I'm just using this offline version. Okay, it is up to you to choose whether online or offline, but the functionalities are same. Okay, and let us get into this. So before getting into this, let us select the interesting sprite. Okay, so I'm just removing this sprite. For removing this sprite, you just right click and you can just delete it. Okay, and let us go to this library, sprite library. Okay, I'm just moving down to select the interesting thing. Okay, little bit, so just little bit, something got stuck. Let us wait, let it get cleared. See here, they're not responding. Sometimes it happens with this MATLAB, sorry, with this Scratch. I'm just again moving it down. Okay, so it got down. So let me choose, oh let us see. Okay, let me choose this dino. Okay, now okay, I'm just clicking okay. Here comes the dino. Okay, let us see what are all the costumes available for this dino. Oh, there are so much of costumes available for this dino that it'll be easy for us to work. Okay, okay, right now let us start with this first block palette, move. If I want my dino to move, that is, let us, if I want my dino to walk, then I'll use this block palette. Okay, so how to take this block palette out of this? So just place the cursor where you want. Okay, I want this first one, so I'm just placing the cursor over here. Click left click mouse button. Okay, just hold the left mouse button so that your block palette will get projected. Then drag and drop into the script area. That's it. So again I'm doing it for you, just hold it, just see this place the cursor over the palette which you need, hold the left mouse button, it gets projected, then drag and drop it to the script area. Okay, and also can you see right now they are separated. Okay, if you want to join, see here, can you see this white? If right now it got joined. Okay, if you want to get separated, yes it is separated. Okay, if they are separated, then you have to click this once for this to perform, and click this block palette again to perform. Okay, but if it is joined together, okay, then one click is enough for moving and turning 15 degrees. Okay, okay, it is up to you to use it combined or use it separately. Okay, it is depend upon your needs. Okay, as of now what I'm going to do is I'm just going to show all the functionalities of this block palettes. Okay, so I'm just making the dino to look like previous one. Okay, and right now let us move this. Okay, so I'm just moving it 50 steps. So it is visible for us to see. Okay, so move 50 steps, which means can you see the dino is moving 50 steps? Okay, so it moved 50 steps. Okay, okay, this thing is over. Right now I'm bringing this 15 degree. If you want the dino or any other sprite to rotate 15 degrees or rotate the degrees which you need in anti-clockwise, then this block palette will be useful. See here, this block palette is useful, right? Yes. Okay, in the same way, if you want to reverse the action, that is if you want to move it in the anti-clockwise direction, then this block will be used. Okay, turn anti-clockwise 15 degrees. You can very well replace the values to 90. Just see here, 90, here also 90. Okay, so you can turn any degrees you want. Okay, so this is the functionality of this two block. Over, I'm just placing it here and point in the direction. Okay, usually the sprites will point towards right direction. If you want to point towards left, up or down, then this block will be used. Okay, so 90 degree means it point towards right direction. If you want to point towards the left, then you have to click minus 90. If you just click on this block palette, it turns. Okay, so it is pointing towards left side. Okay, now if you want to point the upward, then up, that's it. Now it points towards this up direction. Okay, if you want to point towards the down way, downward, just see here, that's it. Okay, so down. So if you want to make the direction, then you can use this block. Okay, so for example, I want my dino to look upward and walk 50 steps. Okay, then what I'll do is up and I'll join this block and make it 50. Okay, if I do this, it turns upwards and walk 50 steps. Shall we see that? Can you see? Yes, it turns upwards and point 50 direction. Okay, similarly, I want to point in the right direction and walk 50 step. Can you see it is walking towards the 50 step? Okay, okay, so that's all for this block. Let us place this block back to this. Okay, now point towards mouse pointer. Okay, so here we have specified the direction, but here you can just place the mouse pointer wherever you want, so that according to that place your dino will face. Okay, right now my mouse pointer is this way here, so it should look this way. Okay, see here, if I click on this block palette, can you see according to this direction it point towards? Okay, now if I go here to the top and if I click, it point. Okay, where my mouse pointer goes, it point towards in this direction. Okay, that's it. Now comes the next. Okay, so X and Y. Okay, so before explaining the rest of the block palettes in this block menu, I would like to take a background here. So let me choose the background from the background library. Oh, let us choose this XY graph. Okay, okay, this XY grid is the background. This is just for your explanation. Okay, as can you see the markings over here, X value 0, Y value 0, X is 240. Similar to this, your X and value differs. Okay, so where if dinosaurus is moving, each point has X and Y values. Okay, so X means towards the horizontal direction, Y means towards the positive, towards the vertical direction. Okay, right now let us see wherever dino is standing. Okay, for which I'm just scrolling down, checking this X position, Y position and direction. Okay, so let me arrange it. Okay, right now my X value is minus 29.5, Y value is 18 and the direction is 71. Okay, so 71 is similar to the left side. Okay, tilted, little bit tilted towards the left side. Okay, okay, now can you see here, go to minus 30, Y 18. It is almost okay. So right now I'm just moving my dino somewhere here and see the X position minus 161 and Y position is minus 102. Okay, right now I want my dino to move to X minus 30 and Y 18. If I click on this, it just moved to that place. Okay, okay, again if I ask the dino to move to X minus 162 to minus 102, see here, it goes to that place. Okay, see here, the X and Y value changes. If I click on this, X and Y value changes. If I click on this, it goes there and X and Y value changes. Okay, we are keeping track what is the X and Y value here. Okay, so right now over with this block, I'm just taking out the next block now. Okay, so here, as we have seen, point towards mouse pointer. Here also is there, go to mouse pointer. So where my mouse pointer is there, you can ask the sprite or any other dino. You can ask this dino or any other sprite to move towards or go towards this mouse pointer. Okay, right now I'm just placing the mouse pointer to the right corner. Okay, so here the left corner. My dino will move to this right corner. Okay, let us see what happens if I click. Okay, can you see it moved towards the right corner? Okay, right now if I place here right bottom corner, let us see what happens. Yes, it got moved, right? So this is same as point towards. Point towards is it just points. It's, if it is a go to, then it moves to that particular place. Okay. Now glide to -205 and -79. Okay. So if you see here, my dino is here. Okay, and I want to see my dino is here. See the x value and y value. X value is 136 and y value is 85. If I want my dino to glide to -205 and -79, then if I just click on this block palette, it just glide to it. Okay, it just made it quickly, right? So I just increase it to 2 seconds and back to the position. If I click, just see here, it is just gliding as like you are skating, right? So it is just gliding to that position. Okay, that's all, it is over. So can you see the difference between go to and this glide? So go to is it just abruptly go to that position, okay? Whereas glide means point by point it just moves. Okay, you can adjust the second also. This is the difference between go to and glide. Okay, glide is something like as you are using skating. Okay, now let us see change. Before that, let us set the x value to 0 and y value to 0. Okay, which means my dino should go to the center of the screen. Okay, right now my x value is 0 and y value is 0. Okay, as you have read it something this concept in graph, okay, in your mathematics similar to this. Okay, right now my dino is at 0, 0. Okay, if I change the x position by 10, okay, it moves horizontally. Just see here, if I click on it, my x position changes by 10, increases by 10. Can you see the x position value? For each click it increases by 10. Okay, and dino moves in x direction, that is horizontal direction. Okay, similarly if I take y value and if I click on it, it moves in vertical direction. Okay, can you see here, it is moving in vertical direction. That's it. Okay, if it is x, it is horizontal direction. If it is y, it is moving in vertical direction. Okay, and now so if you are creating some games like snake games, if you haven't heard what is mean by snake game, just ask your parents. Okay, if it goes to the edge, it has to bounce or it has to say there is an error. For that condition, you can use this block palette. Okay, right now my dino is touching the edge. Okay, if I click on this block palette, it just bounces. Okay, let us check. I'm just clicking on this. Yes, it bounces back. Okay, so this is how this block palette will work. Okay, that's all. Let us place everything here. And then the last thing is rotation style. Okay, so rotation style is something which you can define it. Okay, whether you want to rotate it left to right, or you don't want to rotate, or you want to rotate all around. So that depends on you. Okay, so that rotation style you can set. Okay, so that's all for this video. Okay, so in this video we have seen block palettes and a block menu. I have explained using this dino, and also we have learned x, y values. Okay, x position, y position and direction. Okay, so these are the functionalities of these block palettes. Okay, you just learn, pause the video, learn each block palettes. Okay, and then you can very well create your own animation and games as the block menu learning get increases. Okay, so that's all for this video. We'll meet you in the next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.